Latest facts and figures on the disease. It is a tool that can help both loved ones and doctors. Stephanie Lasky is the program director of the Alzheimer's Association Greater Indiana Chapter. Quite the title there. She joins us now. Tell us a little bit about this special report and what it revealed.
Yeah, so this was a survey of primary care physicians, and what it really revealed is that the medical infrastructure is not prepared to handle the aging population. So we know that our population is getting older, and we know that age is the number one risk factor for Alzheimer's disease. And many, many primary care physicians who we surveyed said that there's not enough specialists to meet the demand currently, let alone an increased demand.
Yeah, and I think we even have a graphic of that. What is it, more than 8 in 10? Mm-hmm. That's the situation with that?
Yeah. Many primary care physicians find themselves at the front line of this disease, and so many of them never received wonderful formal training through their medical education because it wasn't their area of expertise and specialty.
So you're telling people to contact you guys, and so how do they go about doing that?
Yeah, so the best way for people to plug into the association is to call our 800 number helpline. It's staffed 24/7. The number is 1-800-272-3900. And we can help with anything, whether it's I need a piece of literature dropped in the mail about how to talk about driving with my mom, all the way up to we're in a crisis mode at 2 a.m. and we need to talk to a social worker who can help us through this.
Yeah, and it's something that I find that because my dad, his best friend has it. Mm-hmm. And it's just something they don't always want to talk about, but without talking about it, you're not getting enough accomplished on the other end in terms of treatment and how to care for people.
Yeah, exactly. So we know that early diagnosis is so critical, and removing stigma, to your point, is so critical. That early diagnosis lets people plug into treatment or clinical trials to discover new and better treatments, and even just plan for the future, right? Whether it's setting up wills and trusts or having conversations about driving, whatever that might look like.
And we're talking about the future. So what does that look like? I know there's got to be an increasing demand, right?
Absolutely. Huge increasing demand as our population ages, as people live longer. And we just want to make sure that healthcare providers are well equipped to deal with this. So we work on federal and state levels to advocate to make sure that this is a top policy priority. We also work with health systems and physicians offices to provide education and to let them know that their patients can reach out to us 24 hours a day.
What would you tell somebody who is living with this or has a relative? You know, we were talking about the stigma.
Yeah.
It's basically, you know, talk to somebody, don't just hold it in.
Exactly, yeah, talk to us, reach out to us. We're more than happy to help, like I said, with anything, whether it's literature all the way up to crisis mode. We've got people 24 hours a day on that line that can help with whatever the case may be.
And that 1-800, don't tell me, I think I'm 272-3900?
Exactly.
All right, we'll have that on our website. Great. As well, fox59.com. Stephanie, thanks for being
here.
Oh,
thanks for having me.
I would shake your hand, but you know how that goes.
Yep,
this day.
Nope.
All right.